Howdy, 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 and welcome everybody to this joint Dota League Season 13 match here, best of two between Saints Squad Gaming and London Esports. I'm your caster, Spruce Moose. I'll be flying solo today, but let's hopefully we'll have a nice and entertaining best of two series here for you guys and gals. Have a look through the draft so far, what we've got going on. First pick, first bans. So first pick Axe coming through here from London Esports, making his way back into the meta just a little bit. Decent showings at the ESL Major, often combined up there with the Sky Major. We see they have banned that in the first phase there. So bans, Io, Chen, Lesh from Saints Squad. Great early, very strong lane supports coming through. London Esports, they've banned the Doom, Beastmaster and Sky. So fix a bit more on the offlane here, but we had a pretty fast draft so far. Instant Undying Death Rock pickups here from Saints Squad. So again, focused on the strong lanes, Undying, great in this sort of 2-1-2 meta or even the aggro. Rather defensive try, I suppose, against the aggro duel of the Undying. Making his way back into the meta a little bit, which I'm a big fan of. Hopefully we see Death Prophet die off a little bit more, because I'm kind of sick of seeing the hero a little bit more. But super viable, as always. Strong in the lane, hard to gank. Gives you that sort of dead lane setup. Spirit Siphons, making sure you have plenty of regen in the lane without necessarily needing consumables. Great push, great mid-game tempo controller. Let's see what London Esports will respond with then for the DP. Standard pick will be the DK for the mid lane matchup, but it's going to be the Ancient Apparition. Big fan of that versus these two heroes in that opening pick. Prevents the regen and the healing from both the Undying and the DP. Spirit Siphon's not going to do too much. Likewise, Undying as well. So a big fan of that. You could do have a little bit of a setup there of the cool as well for the cold feet. A decent amount of lockdown, decent amount of magical damage so far coming out from London Esports. And we are now into the second phase of banning already. This is a speedy draft. Omnite coming out. Okay, again, focusing on those offlane heroes. Phantom Lancer being banned by Saints Squad. We did see PL get a little bit of a nerf in the most recent patch. I believe it was the root now. It's no longer dispelled by Doppelganger, which certainly brings down the viability of the heroes somewhat in my eyes. Making heroes like Ember Spirit all the better against it. But banning wise, again, Lone Druid. Gonna be banned out here by London Esports. Sometimes played as the offlaner, but it's normally that sort of solo lane. Carry essentially can be run mid, can be run in either the other side lanes as well. Hard to gank, hard to pressure. Just ban it out, why not? And seeing the squad here taking a little bit of time to think about that, but as I say it, Windrunner will be that fifth ban. Definitely a hero, but hero I reckon will be a bit more viable coming through in the pro meta. Borderline broken in pubs, in my opinion. Super flexible. Sort of might slot into that kind of Lesh rack position. Early pick in the draft. Flexible, can be run in all sorts of positions. Tusker. And then we're going to go for the Tusker. Okay, well that's some initiation. Small lane control and harass coming through. I can see that with the Tombstone into the Shards. Could be a lot of area control. London Esports, what are we going to go for third pick here? So they've got their offlane, I assume. It's going to be an offlane Axe. We don't often see it running anywhere else. I believe it was Pycat. Pycat obviously playing the classic carry Axe for Optic Gaming at recent ESL Major. A little bit of a throwback there. But not the standard. I imagine they will pick up their position 4 probably now. Although it might just be, they might go for a core pick if they want to get that out of the way early. But they are taking their time to think about it here. Oh, they go. Well, they okay. All right, straight up there. With the Faceless Void classic combination with the AA for the Ice Blast ulti combination with the Chronosphere. Have to be careful about the silence on the Death Prophet, and Tombstone can also be pretty annoying. And there we go. Talking of annoying, talking of heroes you didn't really want to lane against as the Faceless Void, Venomancer. Boom. damage over time, basis for its natural enemy in the laning phase. Can't time walk it off if you've been poison stung for about a billion magical damage. So I'm quite liking the shape of Saint Squad's draft so far. Very early kind of tempo push sort of draft. Throw down the tombstone, throw down the wards, great siege with the exorcism as well. It's not too much that esports have at the moment. Just kind of de-push and prevent that sort of slow siege coming through from Saint Squad at the moment. I expect them, London Esports here, to pick up something that can offer that D push. Maybe something like the mid leaner, even the Shadow Fiend. Something, you just need something that shoves in the waves, right? Let's do the Blitz. You've got to shove in the waves. You need to D push these waves. Axe, it's okay, but he's got to put his body in the way. Void, not a great wave pushing hero. AA, also pretty terrible. So you might see maybe they pick up the Sand King, which can do it a little bit himself as well. Maybe the Shaman. Also offers a little bit of a wave shove in the form of the position 4 they could pick up. Probably expect to see them pick up the position 4 now. It's going to be the Zeus, okay. So that's a little bit of that wave shove. Now we have seen them run this as a position 4. So this could be the position 4 Zeus. It could be the mid Zeus. Also great team fight combination. Plenty of magical damage coming through with the AA with the magic amp. Zeus, of course, just zap, 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 zap. Magical damage out the wazoo. A great team fight as well with the Chronosphere. Get that Nimbus as well. You can have a huge amount of area control, a huge amount of area deny. I dig that. The only other thing they are lacking as well is a way to take down that tombstone somewhat. AA can hit it from pretty far, but doesn't have the fastest attack speed. Void's okay. But again, you've got to get up close and personal. So I'd maybe like to see them go for... yeah, the Lina. I think the Lina mid would be a nice pickup here. So we might see what... see if Saint Squad are going to ban that out here in the next phase. Is the last ban coming through now? I assume, of course, the Saint Squad will be a mid Death Prophet. Probably offlane Venno, I reckon, doing the sort of dual lane. But we could see a safe lane Venno Mance. We have seen that a few times. Doesn't matter too much, really. It's about where you want to put the pressure in those lanes. Oh, no, they're going to ban the Earth Spirit. Okay, they think it's a mid Zeus. Let's see, last ban here for London Esports. And seconds left on the clock. I'm not too sure what Saint Squad are looking for here. If they want to have a carry, they can take it a little bit later. Maybe another utility core. They could do a bit more lockdown. They've only really got the one stun. That's just a snowball on a single target. But they have a crazy amount of slow. So they'll ban the Brewmaster. Okay, offer some more control, more push as well. Disruption in the team fights. That's a respectable ban. We have the last pick here for London Esports. Still need that D push. Zeus does it somewhat, but I'm thinking this is going to be the position for Zeus.
10 seconds remaining.
Made a little bit more viable in the recent patch, of course.
5 seconds remaining. Radiant team pick.
Oh, it's the Phoenix. Okay, maybe it is the mid Zeus then. They're going to be what? Dual lane? AA Axe, Phoenix Void? That is a crazy wombo combo there. The Chronosphere Phoenix. We saw OG ripping a little bit of that. Going back in time. Fly on the Phoenix. Okay. Lots of magical damage. Again, Saint Squad, they don't have the way to deal with the egg particularly well. Likewise, London don't have the best way to deal with the tombstone. So, egg for tombstone, tit for tat. Similar style spells in these sort of team fights. What is Saint Squad going to go for then in response? I do wonder. Depends where they want to throw these heroes in the lanes. They could even go something like a Vengeful Spirit carry. I think you're pretty decent. Nice tempo. Gives you a bit more physical damage that they are lacking. a bit more lockdown, but also more pushing power. Not the greatest wave clear though. Again, the only real wave clear you've got is the DP. Tusk's okay, I suppose, as a position 4. It's gonna be the troll, okay. I was wondering about that. I thought, nah. A classic counter there towards the Phoenix. You pop the battle trance, and just start smacking that egg. Draft wise, got the Wombo combo potential for London Esports. That's going to be exciting to watch. But in terms of laning pressure, I think Saints squad will come up with the upper hand. So I'm going to give them the tip for game one here. But hopefully we do have an entertaining best of two here for you guys. If you are just joining, welcome. I'm Spruce Music Casting. This joined Dota League Season 13 best of two. Saints squad versus London Esports here. Do a little bit of a rundown. Now we've got Mad Kings here on the axe. Come with me. We're picking up the AA. We've got a Gibby, however you want to call them, on the Faces Void. Standing. Blank name on the Zeus and Xiaoli there on the Phoenix. Meanwhile, for Saints squad, we've got Black Archangel on the Undying, Sailor on the Death Prophet, XS Vampire on the Tusk, Massacre on the Venno, and Nefri picking up that Troll Warlord. I'm just waiting here for this Street Fighter intro, Bish Bash Bosh, and we will get into the game. Laning setup wise. Troll plus one. Troll. Probably Troll Tusk, I reckon. Do the Venno Undying for like the super, super aggressive offlane. Here we go. Let's hop in. Hopefully we do have an exciting game here for you guys. Looks to be Axe Phoenix running down bottom. It's going to be the AA Void combo then. As already, we're off to a tip. It's going to be an aggro try. Support Venno, perhaps. Offlane Undying. Plenty of mana regen. Because it is going to be that mid Death Prophet versus the mid Zeus matchup. Nothing too untoward there. See your board plopped down here by Phoenix. We're spotting out that bounty ring rotations and then not gonna block the pulls, but we'll be able to see them going on. Have a likewise a defensive ward mirrored on the other side of the map. Prevent those rotations looping around behind, preventing interrupts to the pulls as well. See the Undying here. Still hanging on to his ward, but being pinged out. A little standoff here in the bottom side of the map for this rune. Here we go. Mad Kings runs himself forward. Just going to posture. He'll grab his rune. That should be a three runes from London Esports here on the dire side. Easy peasy. Lemon squeezy. But laning wise... Oh no, they're going to put the troll up top then. It does look to be that Troll Undying dual lane then, and they're going to do the Venno Tusk in the bottom lane. Their ward will be spotted out. Does block this camp. It's going to be slightly difficult to deward, but they should be able to get it there. As we see, come with me. Ooh. Pop down that ward. Easy deward there. Claims the 100 gold and the little bit of XP that comes with it. Up in this top lane now. Troll versus Faces Void. With the Undying. It's going to be a pretty tough lane here for the Void. Does have that Time Walk though. Always available. So you shouldn't really die. But CS wise, you might struggle a little bit here. With the constant harass of this Undying. Spamming out this Decay is already up to 12 stacks there. I see Axe actually go for the level 1 Battle Hunger here to try and harass back Massacre here on the Venomancer. Middle lane matchup wise, I think it's going to be relatively even. We do see Zeus taking a little bit more harass at the start as we see Sailor here pressuring the wave underneath the tower, making it harder for the Zeus to last it. So he doesn't want to keep spamming those arc lines to last it. And so it is mana intensive. We see Xiaoli here in trouble, gets caught by the Gale, goes for the TP. No shards available, no snowball available. And he will get himself out of there, no problem. Back to base, they only have to make the long walk back to the lane. Just give them a bit of free reign here to pressure the Axe. Double Mango Troll Warlord. Thought we were over Mango Gaming. Ginny Touch comes out here from Come With Me. Just trying to get a little bit harassed here onto Nefrit, but not going to happen. Plenty healthy there. Still another four tangos in the inventory, but the clarity will be cancelled. But Undying, not too bothered. He's pretty much at full mana there. Has a stick now. Two mangoes still to work with. They pull the creep wave back around. We see Axe here. Trying to go for a pull, but might be in trouble here. The Gale comes through. Snowball will cancel the TP. Here comes Shaylee. Can they bring anybody down? Doesn't look like it. They're going to trade some blows. But Axe will get away thanks to the help there of the Phoenix. Tusk does have a mango to work with. Axe will throw out the Battle Hunger there just to harass him back a little bit. Surprisingly there, no one goes down. Thought they might get a little bit more aggressive here on the Radiant side of Saints. It's not to be. Cold Feet will proc up here onto Nefrit, but again, no follow up. Just a little bit of harass here as he continues to CS. How are we doing in this mid lane? Oh, actually, down bottom. T-Tours. Jowly claims first blood there, gets the Tusk. Will trade. Massacre will find the kill there in return. Pops the salve. Instantly back into the lane to harass Mad Kings here with that level 2 poison sting. Up top, meanwhile. Oh, there we go. AA does drop Nefrit finding the kill. There's a 2-1 score quickly here. His face is void. Forced back underneath the tower. CS-wise, they're doing pretty well on the side of London Esports here. 20-4 on the Zeus versus 12-1 on that Death Prophet. So not a huge amount of denies for either one. But Zeus definitely winning the little CS war here. We have a little tip for the Axe. Well played. And it doesn't look like he's going to go for that Vanguard first before the blink on the Axe. And oh my goodness. Middle lane. Zeus will go down. So nice rotation there from Excess Vampire on the Tusker. Does find the kill onto the Zeus. Much needed as he was pulling ahead there in the CS. We're going to see Illusion Runes coming through here. Picked up by the Ancient Apparition. Just slap the Undying a little bit here as he moonwalks himself away. Down bottom. Shards here onto Shaoli. Trying to turn it back around here. The Vampire here. The magic damage coming through from these spirits. Actually doing a lot. Battle Hunger chasing down the Venomancer on the other side. Can they find the Tusk? One more hit. We'll find him. No, Snowball there to try and keep himself alive for a little bit longer. But I don't think he's going to be able to get himself away from this. As Icarus Dive comes forward and they do find the kill there onto the Tusker. Can they find a secondary kill to Massacre? Shaoli, forget about it. Nope. Duke himself in the trees. Pops the Fairy Fire. He will stay alive there on about 100 HP. That's going to TP himself to that shrine, which is available in about 8 seconds. Up top lane. How are we doing CS-wise? Avoid doing pretty well. 25-2. Actually exactly matching the troll. 25-2 for both. Didn't even trade up top for the two safe lanes, essentially. Well, safe lane cores, position ones, whatever you want to call them these days. Lanes that really have a name as much anymore as they used to do. What about the optimal matchups here? We're going to have a man fight here. Time walk already been used. Pull down for Toy Suckers. Trying to turn around here. Can they get the bash? Who gets the bash first? It's going to be the troll. With the hill coming through there from the Undying, they do find that face is void. And that's perhaps a fight he probably didn't want to take. As it will be now 4-2 the score. In favor Saints here, as we see Mad Kings going for the little pull here. Shards will connect. Massacre connects the Venomous Gale as well, but Mad Kings standing strong, pretty tanky, already on 1k HP. Just go throw out the Battle Hunger Terrace instead and just go back to chopping on some creeps. You're gonna see Nefrit and Black here. They're just gonna shrine themselves up. Regen Rune on the bottom side of the river. Gale here onto two. Massacre. Shards coming through. And Shaylee dives himself away. Is it going to be far enough? No, it's not. Snowball connects, but is it enough damage? Yes, it is. It's Vampire now. Maybe in a little bit too deep, but Mad King is getting chopped here by the Venomancer. Slowed down by the Poison Sting. Zeus rotates over, though, with the ult. Brings down the Venomancer. Dives a little bit too far. Mad King is still alive. Has the Poison Sting on him, but it's certainly not going to bring him down. Thunderbolt will find him there. And the Arc Lightning double kill there for the Zeus. Fantastic rotation. Phoenix picks up a little bit of experience there in the middle lane while he was missing. They go for the dive of the Axe. They do find the Phoenix at least, but quick, swift return kill there as London Esports bring it back around 11 in the score out, a little bit 5-4 now, nearly 7 minutes in. We do have the Chronosphere available, have yet to see it so far this game. Well, Icarus dive forward here. Masca, look at that damage coming through from the Phoenix with the Fire Spirits. And there's the chop, chop, dunk. Mad Kings finds the kill there. Tusk looking for a revenge kill, but he's not going to find it. And in fact, oh no. Gibby, he's going to go down. Spinning Blades of Fury here from Nefrit. Chop him down. And once again, the Faceless Void will fall 20 seconds on the sideline where he's not farming. But he's still top of the CS charts here, 39-4. So a much needed kill. The Saints is actually going to find a secondary one. Come with me in trouble. Pops the one. Try to keep himself alive. But there's the Bash to Cold Feet. He's not going to proc an effort. Runs himself away. Actually can come with me. Juke himself through this. Goes through the trees. Breaking ankles. Going to catch the creep wave though. And it gives him the vision here for Nefrit. Throws the axes. Gets the slow. Facing him down. Another Cold Feet proc. Couple more slaps. They will find it. And that's going to be a dominating streak now for this Troll Warlord. Nice attempt there by the Ancient Apparition to come with me. But doesn't find the Duke there. Thanks to the creep wave. DD rune in the bottom side of the river. Don't think it's been spotted out yet. Yes, it has. Zhao Li going for it. No, Massacre. It'll go for the deny. Standing gets the Thunderbolt, though. Bring out a little bit of harass. Oh, ping is coming out. They want this Phoenix. Massacre rotating over. Spirits come out though with the Battle Hunger, doing a decent amount of damage here. Icarus dives away, dodges the Venomous Gale, doesn't connect onto anybody. Mad King's chasing forward. The Shards, a nice block there from XS Vampire. Will save the life there of the Venomancer, but instead up top, they're chasing here, trying to bring down Come With Me. Void does have, no, doesn't have the Chrono, has already used it. Didn't see that one. The Spinning Axes does come through, does bring him down. Can he find the secondary kill on the Faceless Void now as well? Time walk up in 4 seconds, has 8 stick charges. Nah, he should be fine. Pops the self, warps himself back towards the tower. Need to see us here. Exorcism being used here by Sailor, trying to push in this tier 1 tower. Trying to turn around here onto Mad Kings with the Spirit Siphon, but it's actually just a bait. Zekris Dives comes forward here, standing, rotating through as well here with the Zeus. Gets the Thunderbolt out. Is it going to be enough damage? The chop is there! Massacre rotates in, but is not able to do too much. Only still level 5 on this Venomancer, so doesn't have the Poison Nova to offer in these teamfights. And the tanky, tanky axe there with the Vanguard keeps himself alive. As they bring down that Death Prophet. 2k up now for London Esports. The score 8-6. But economically, they're doing pretty nicely. You see, top of the net worth is actually going to be the Axe himself. Mad Kings here. Pretty nice. Who needs boots when you've got Battle Hunger, eh? He does look to pick up the brown boots at the side shop, finally. He's going left alone in this bottom lane now. He's kind of do what he wants. Venomancer retreat into the jungle a little bit. He's coming out. Death Prophet. Duke's into the Roche pit. Look to try and make a go here. Undying and Troll running forwards. No, Zeus going to immediately TB. Is the Snowball going to be there in time? It is not. Back to the T1 tower in mid. Nice play. Quick thinking. Gets the Zeus out of trouble. And Mad Kings, Chronosphere now available. If they do want to make something of this, they can do. Zeus ult available in 20 seconds. The Axe here, having a lovely time, cutting this bottom wave. T1 tower will shortly fall. Glyph will come out, but just denying the inevitable here. But it's a freebie, why not? Slows it down ever so slightly. We do get the 200 bonus gold there to Mad Kings. Now only 600 gold away from that Blink Dagger, with the Vanguard already completed. So he's going to have a very healthy timing indeed. There we go, Zeus ult at the ready. Zhao Li still not quite yet level 6. No egg to combo up with the team. But it doesn't look like they need it so much in these fights. One with me also still level 5, but closer to level 6 than the Phoenix. Venomancer is so far, but it is behind net worth of the Phoenix. They've absolutely shut down this Veno. Venopic kind of intended to do the opposite, you know? Just give you the strong lane and shut down the enemy lane of it. It's, in fact, the Banana Slug himself has been shut down. We see the Zusak, oh, come out in the middle. The help of the Phoenix to do find that Death Prophet. Things up top. Zeus rotates. They know they want to make a go here on this top lane. He's gonna tuck himself there into the trees. He's gonna try and bait something out, maybe. Rune Spheres available coming through. There we go, Kex onto two, perfectly on the two sides. AA coming through, does have the level 6, Icebox will throw it, like, oh, he catches the task with the Thunderbolt comes through. Tombstone dropped here by Black Alexandria, now at London, trying to run themselves away. Ultimate popped here by the Undying, but in fact, he's going to just get turned around on. It gets the heal off, time walk forward, though, from the Void. Trying to bring him down, a Decay, though, keeping himself alive. Axe is flying through on the other side of this fight, but they're cutting around beautifully. The Troll will fall. Likewise, Black Alexandria, the burn coming through from the Phoenix, is it going to be enough? No, it's not, the heals are there, no, Icarus dive. Spirits. Not quite connecting. He's going to stay alive in about 60 HP. Come on, he's on the backside of the fight, also staying alive somehow. Cold Feet will now trigger onto this Death Prophet, and looks to be the fight is over. Everyone else wants to back themselves out. Just Exorcism. Just trying to pressure into tower, but here comes Mad Kings. He's chilling in the trees. He's got his Blink Dagger. Massacre misses the Gale again, this time onto Face of Void. That call coming through, catches him with Blink Dagger. Ice Blast flying through, the chop is there. Ice Blast not even needed. Death Prophet gets eviscerated, 30 seconds down. That's a secondary kill. So much magical damage coming through from this Zeus. They get the Poison Nova out, which will actually bring down Shaoli there onto the Phoenix, but it's a consolation prize at anything. Void, oh, he's ticking low, does have the one charge. Nah, he's going to be fine. All dropping low, but only the Phoenix to fall. London Esports walk themselves back to base and count themselves very, very happy with that engagement. 6k up now in the net worth. The score 9 to 11, but kills don't mean too much in the meta these days. It's all about that net worth. It's all about those objectives. Troll, how's he doing? So he's going for the Battle Fury. So they want to try and slow this play. I was going to say, slow the pace down, but London Esports not letting up. Ice Blast flying through there brings down the Undying. Excess Vampire trying to make the space here with the Snowball. Be able to keep himself alive. Dodging the Wrath of the Zeus here, who does have the full Veil of Discord now picked up. An insane amount of magical bursts coming through now from the Zeus. Looking to go for the Aether Lens next. Pretty standard bottom. Come with me, just trying to get some wards out. Might be in trouble. Snowball coming forward, picks up the Troll. Mid Cold Feet. Wraps him forward. One more. Throw there the axes, then we'll find the kill. But look, here it is. It's Faceless Void. Comes through here with the time lock. Has the Cronus Fave. Is he going to drop it here? Yes, he will. Just to cancel the TP here on the Troll. Where's the follow-up damage? Sunray coming through the Phoenix. Zeus ult comes through as well. With the Bash proc coming through, and then one charge not going to be enough. Actually, it was the heal there, sorry, of the Underlord. But here comes the egg. Just trying to secure the kill there. Of course, the Undying back. Not really needed in the end. They should be able to claim this tier 2 tower. They're looking for more. Scan coming through, but it's not going to connect onto anything as you see the Death Prophet up top, just trying to equal out these lanes a little bit. Exorcism is up in about 3 seconds. The Glyph will come through here aggressively and defensively from London Esports. Very nice timing here. They look to pressure and defend at the same time as the Axe up here. Mad Kings, he's hunting. Is he going to find the Banana Slug? That is the question. They're going to be cancelled there by the Poison Sting, but does grab the Bounty Rune. Exorcism used here by Sailor does claim that tier 1 tower. And London Esports not able to do too much damage here onto this tier 2. Still got about 2/3 of its life left. How are we doing item wise? Troll, top of his team, but only 4th overall. Still trying to make his way towards the Battle Fury. Has the Perseverance and the recipe with the Ring of Killer Phase Boots, but he's not a happy chappy, relatively speaking. We have a whole Midas here on this Phoenix. Gonna be looking for the Urn of Shadows into the Spirit Vessel next. AA. Just playing the position 6. I mean, pretty standard AA things. This Void, he's looking for his own Battle Fury. As the treads are killer completed with the Demon Edge. Should get there a little bit ahead of the Troll. Dying. He's just doing undiving. Looking for the Hood. Probably transition that into a pipe, I imagine. Likewise, Hood will be picked up here by the DP. Veno, 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 how are you doing? Classic cloak. Hoods all around. You get a Hood. You get a Hood. Everybody gets a Hood. Scan does connect. Spot out the smoke here from London Esports. They're trying to catch out the Death Prophet there. Can they find her in time? Doesn't it like it? They're trying to wrap around here to pressure this tier 1 tower. Charge will fly through though from the Tusk. Trying to slow it down a little bit. Mackin's going to jump himself into the trees here with Come With Me. Saints squad, they're aware of this movement. Thanks for that scan. They know something's up. Void, meanwhile, down bottom. Continuously farming. Dying. TP himself away, but... Oh, blink forward here for Mad Kings. Doesn't quite catch the Tusk in time. Thanks to Snowball, the Warrior's Punch there. But dodge the chop, but he will also go down. Nonetheless, Ed coming through with the Poison. Mad King's taking a lot of magical damage here. The Soul Sun's coming through. Come with me, gets the double kill, though, bringing down the Venomancer. Tusk will buy back in this fight. Ed connects, though, onto Sailor. And this might be the end of it. No Chronosphere there, drop down onto two. Does trap up the Phoenix as well, though, but Zeus still outping a huge amount of damage. Thundergod Wrath coming through there. Brings down three. That's a dieback for the Tusk. Archangel here on the side of this fight. Still getting chopped down here by the Zeus, but he's running low on the mana. Just going to go for the TP instead. They don't really have a way to deal with that team stone. They're going to try and farm it up now. The two long-range supports, but they are pretty low. Oh, there we go. There's a Soul Rip coming through. That's a freebie. They get a Constellation kill on the AA, at least. Troll. Successfully, we have to pressure the top lane somewhat. We'll force rotation here from the Zeus. Another Esports looking good in these fights, but they're not really taking the objectives. So don't really have the team, you know, easily able to do that. Faces Void, the only real tower hitter of the team. I mean, Axe can cut the waves. But in terms of Siege, in terms of raw tower take compared to the Radiant side here, they are lacking somewhat. You get the Exorcism, you've got the Venom, you've got the Troll. All classic Siege heroes. Axe gets a blink call here, but it's under three heroes. AA Blast going to connect onto every... No, the Snowball there to save and dodge the initial damage. Mad King surely will go down here. Warrior's Punch flying through, and they're just going to abandon him here. Just come with me. We'll go down as well. Zeus ult comes through, and they do find the Troll kill actually off the back of that. So that's a nice consolation prize. They've got the Exorcism ready to rumble here. The Saints squad take this tier 1 with this Exorcism. It's pretty low. I don't even know if they want to use the Exorcism for this. Just gonna try and chip it away. The Glyph does come out here from London Esports. No more creeps. Left the tank up that tower. And that looks to be that. Rightio. Massacre here. Good completed. Try and de-push this bottom lane. See the Void here. How's he doing? Has his full Battle Fury now. Looking for the Shadow Blade. Troll, likewise. He's going straight into that BKB. Knowing the urgency of the team and the tempo they're trying to play at. Opts to go for that second item BKB. Negate some of that damage coming through. Well, most of the damage coming through from the Zeus, from the Phoenix. Of course, Chronosphere. Can't BKB a Chronosphere. Can't BKB an Axe Call. But it is going to do a lot to negate the damage coming out from London Esports in these team fights. Oh. Oh no, Troll spotted out here. The Cold Feet, the Ice Blast, the Chronosphere. Everything goes down there. It's now a killing spree. Mad King shows up just at the end of the smoke going, can I get a chop chop? But they bring him down a little bit too quickly there. And that Troll, back-to-back deaths now. He is not a happy bunny. He's still farming pretty well though. Now third on the net worth, thanks to that Battle Fury. Has overtaken Mad King's here on the Axe now. Speaking of which, is looking for his blade mail next. Down bottom. Ings coming out. Sailor. Black here, they're wrapping themselves around. Oh, Shali gonna be spotted out. Gets the essential ward down. Icarus dives away. We do have the flesh golem popped here now by the Undying. And the Exorcism is gonna be committed here by Sailor. Snowball forwards, gets the voice punch there onto the Phoenix. Egg will be dropped. They're gonna go to town trying to punch into it. The Zeus trying to do his best. Tombstone drop down. Look at the damage graph. They do bring down the egg, but they lose the tusk. Undying dropping very low. Uses the soul rope, trying to bring himself back up to some decent amount of HP, but he's going to, in fact, just TP himself away. As you see, the plague wards and the exorcism and the creeps go to town now on this tier 1 tower in the bottom lane. Mad Kings and come with me, they do manage to trade. They get the tier 1 tower there on the top side of the map. They're going to need to back themselves out potentially here. Or actually just look to keep going. They do have the Siege Cart wave here, pushing into this tier 2. Dying's going to show up here to try and de-push, but it's an Undying. He's going to do Freeze Decay on the creeps and slowly punch them. So see Mad Kings sitting in the trees waiting for initiation here. With the creep wave, there it is. There's the blink call with the blade mail. Ice Blast coming through as well. And that's a quick and easy setup kill there. And this tier 2 tower now under threat. Tusk's in a shop as well to try and help. A little bit better at clearing these creeps than the Undying. That tower is still going to take a big old chunk of damage. What's that on now? 397. Ouchie. Roll though, getting ever closer to their BKB. King's coming out. Eventually going to see a Nye hit yet on the middle tower. Nicely done. Ooh, Spirit Vessel now picked up by Phoenix. This Phoenix is farmed, man. Done right. Chronosphere spots out the troll. And that was a DD pickoff as well with the fresh Shadow Blade coming through here from a Jibi here on this Faces Void. And now they look to pressure this tier 2, all right. Shards coming through will be spotted out though. Bill. But Tusk has enough space to get himself away for now. Oh, Mad Kings catches out the Venom. No creeps for the Almighty Spins, but gets a couple. Venusville comes out there. He's got the Blade Mail. Try and chase him down now with the Battle Hunger. Hood popped. Ice Blast going to fly through, but the Blink from Massacre bags the Hood. He's able to blink himself away there. Clever play. Keeps himself back to base. Zeus with the BTs. He does indeed. Ball Staff, Aether Lens, Veil of Disco. Ooh, he is farmed. Very, very farmed. 10k net worth now on the Zeus. Faces Void. I imagine he'll probably go for BKB, Lincolns, or something like that next. Defensive Iron, yeah, it's going to be the BKB. That's the key. It's Phoenix. Straight up Shivas, alright. Axe looking for a BKB of his own. But here comes the play from Saints Gaming. Arias can't take a straight up fight. Let's get an Aegis. Great team to do it with the troll, with the Exorcism committed as well. Tusk sitting outside here with the smoke, still invised up. Potential down, but it's going to be spotted out here by the Ice Blast. It will fly through. Next on to two. But a little bit too late. Aegis already taken underneath spots. They're running themselves over to the pit here. Icarus dive coming through there from Shaoli. Silence stop those. Shards will connect as well. Snowball running forward. Walrus punch. Lots of damage going here onto this Phoenix. Gripstorm as well. Guys, get the egg off though. Tombstone dropped. Mad Kings can't get into this fight thanks to all the Plague Wards here. But on the backside of this fight comes the Faceless Void. Has to Time Walk himself away. Doesn't want to initiate into four heroes by himself. Shadow Blade. No Chronosphere for 10 seconds. And a little bit of an awkward engagement there from both sides as nobody goes down. But, ooh, is that an Arcane Rune for Zeus? Hello. That's going to hurt if they take this fight. London Esports, they're pushing against an Aegis, but they don't really care. They're 14k up. I'm going to see the Shards coming through here, trying to de-push. Shove those creeps back down the lane. Mad Kings, he goes, I don't care. I'm just going to slap your tower slowly and surely. It's a Void there. We'll claim the last hit and the bonus gold for it. Unsure across the map. They want Sailor here on this Death Prophet. Yules completed, Hood completed. Probably looking for the BKB next as well. But we spotted here by the Zeus. Thunderbolt comes out. Hood off cooldown in 1 second, but she's pretty nippy with the phase boots. Thundergod's Wrath comes out. Arc Lightning as well. Trying to chase her down. And on the other side of the fight, the Axe catches out Massacre here with the Sunray and the Dunk. They do find that kill. Still trying to chase for the Death Prophet, but a quick TP. She gets herself out of there. No cancel ready for that. There's no Yules on the Zeus. Cold Feet doesn't proc in time. They do get the Venomancer, who... Bless him, he's not having the nicest game, is he, to be honest? Neither of them are, really. Both sat at 8k, nearly 2k behind a Phoenix. Feels bad, man. And that's your position 4. How's Undying doing? Has his Hood completed? We'll be looking for that pipe. He's going to be the one to pick it up. We see creeps once again smashing into this tower. Nobody here to de-push. Tusk running his way over. Still trying to look for that Blink Dagger 26 minutes in. Brown Boots earn. Not a lot else. This is, of course, warded up here. Out of sight of the Sentry Ward. Spot Nefrit rotating over. He's working his way towards the Aghanim Scepter now. As the point booster. Needs another 1600 gold or so. We could have a double pipe. Massacre's got a pipe as well. Dying. Ooh, okay, double pipe. New meta, boys. Double pipe. Mad King's pressuring this bottom lane once again. Use the cool, in fact, just to clear the creeps a little bit quicker. I think they're going to get this tier 2 uncontested. Doesn't look like Saints want to try and contest this too much. Ice Blast does fly out there onto Sailor. They're actually going to be looking for the Aeon Disc as his defensive item. That's all outer towers now taken by London Esports. 27 minutes in. Despite not having a very aggressive fishing lineup, but they are 18k net worth ahead. And it's going to be ever increasing. This little trifecta of wards here. The Radiant Jungle. Didn't quite spot out the one they've got. Do so, just use the scout a little bit there. Give the Chrono Sphere available, but no Shadow Blade. Good play at defense. They want to push these lanes down. London Esports are in no rush to end this. See this one here. This one here. Not spotted out at all by any of these three wards. What's the troll doing? Doesn't use BKB now, at least. Aegis. Can't have too long left on it, maybe a minute or two. Radiant's bottom tower is under attack. But I reckon another new sport is probably just going to try and shove in these lanes here. Radiant's bottom tower is under attack. Yeah, big old circle drawn on the map. Troll, it goes, right? This is my farming space now. They earn our jungle. I'm going to farm their jungle. It's a smart move to make. Do you just go TP down though? We have a little bit of a fight going off here in the middle lane. Axe catches out Maskell. Watch the Ice Blast flies through, and it's actually going to be Phoenix that finds the kill. Warrior's Punch coming out. Quick blink away there. The Void can be spotted out here thanks to the Sentry. Tries to bring down the Tombstone, but here comes a nice double silence from Sailor. The BKB is popped there. Bash, bash, bash. Master Time Walk himself awaiting a lot of damage through, but the egg comes through on the backside of this fight here with the Icarus Drive. Chronosphere there onto two as well. Brings down the Death Prophet. Buyback coming through for the Veil. So he does get the Poison Nova off onto the Faceless Void, but he does Time Talk himself away. Mad Kings just chopping down this Tombstone. I'm not sure he's standing against the world, standing against all these zombies, still somehow alive. Thank you for it all, trusting in his team. And Massacre, it's going to be a dieback there. Godlike Streak now, the Zeus. And they just called it. GG, well played. That was a beating. My oh my. Game one. The London Esports. GG. Tips coming out there. Mad Kings there. Oh, an excellent game on the Axe. Let's have a quick old look at the stats then at the end of this game. A little bit of an anticlimax there. All the building up into it. And then, ooh, quick fight, quick end. Couple of diebacks there. You're going to do that. Two Saints squad can come back here for game two in this best of two series and trying to even out the score. But so far, London Esports looking pretty dominant. 3-6-15 on the AA, 4-2-12 on the Zeus, 9-1-13 on that Zeus. Phoenix having an incredible game as well. Despite not having a really good way to deal with the Tombstone, it didn't really matter because it was so far ahead economically. Troll never really got into the game. Steady decline. Me oh my. Alright. Have a little bit of comp with me's profile there. Thanks for watching so far, guys. I have been Spruce Moose casting this joined at a leak. Season 13 game between London Esports and Saints Squad game. We will be right back for game 2. Do stay tuned.